A very pleasant good day, my beloved brothers and sisters in Christ and outside the body of Christ. Well, once again, this is your Christian brother Eric Braxton speaking to you all from his beloved country Trinidad and Tobago, the land of my nativity, the land of my birth, Trinidad and Tobago, this wonderful island country that is in the blue Caribbean Sea, speaking to you all in the month of September 2019. Brothers and sisters, in this part 6 video, I want to start off in this new teaching on reincarnation. I am simply saying the Bible do not teach reincarnation, and reincarnation is a doctrine that divides mankind. How can I prove that? Well, the Christians do not believe in reincarnation, the Hindus believe in reincarnation, and many people who is non-Christian do not believe in reincarnation. So there is not a oneness in thought there. So therefore, it causes a divide. As I said, the sun, the moon, and the wind, and the earth is not dividing mankind. Because we all benefiting from the same sun, the whole of mankind. There's a oneness there. We all benefiting from the same wind, air, the breath of life. That is a oneness. We all drinking in the same water. That is a oneness. We all have the same blood, because God, in the book of Acts, God who made all nations of one blood to dwell upon the earth. That is a oneness. Look at the white man, the black man, the Indian, the Chinese, the same red blood. So there is oneness again. Is mankind upon two different earths? No, the whole of human family upon one earth, so there's a oneness, and that oneness is coming from God. So then what is dividing mankind, or one of the things that divided mankind? Philosophy and doctrines. And reincarnation is one of that doctrine. Now, brothers and sisters, if that oneness is coming from God, as I best described there, the wind, the air, the sun, the breeze, the blood, You mean on top of that, God will give us different philosophies to follow to divide us? No, he have to, how much doctrine he have to give the whole of mankind? One philosophy. Why? Because it's one air mankind is breathing in. If God have to give the human family one doctrine to follow, he give the human family one doctrine. Why? Because all human beings have the same blood. Will God give us different philosophies and ideologies to follow? No. He gave us one philosophy to follow. Why? Because there's one sun shining upon mankind. Will God give the human family different philosophies and ideologies to follow, to divide them? No. Why? Because the human family is upon one earth. So you see, once again, are you all understanding the one principle, my dear brothers and sisters? Are you all comprehending it? Well, try to understand it. So, remember what Jesus Christ said. I and my Father is one. He's teaching us the one principle. I and my Father is one. So, brothers and sisters, and before, so in part 6 video, we will move on to part 7. We will continue on this serious topic. Brothers and sisters, this what I'm going to drop here is a bombshell. It's a bombshell. And if no one is not teaching you all this, I am personally teaching and revealing this to you all. Now, I want you all to make a very interested observation on YouTube, on Facebook, on Twitter, and on the internet. You all will discover discover what I'm talking about. Because I want you all are blind to it, eh? I am seeing it by the grace of God, but you all are blinded. You all are not seeing it because you all are in gross ignorance, and therefore I am teaching you all that. So without further ado, let us get in that the meat of that matter one time. Brothers and sisters, listen to me very carefully. This is a bombshell. This is an eye-opener. Brothers and sisters, if you all observe on YouTube and on the internet very carefully, there are many people teaching reincarnation from the Hindu scriptures and Bhagavad Gita. There are many researchers doing research on reincarnation. There are many boys and girls claiming they live in past lives and they reincarnate now, brothers and sisters. And there are many people who claim that they reincarnate right up on this earth right now. And researchers going to trace them and find out. And do investigation, and the researchers is authenticating that what these little boys and girls are saying, they live in past lives, the same what they say in H2. I am saying all that is alive. Now, brothers and sisters, I'll show you where I'm coming from. Now, in the Hindu scriptures and the Bhagavad Gita, they teach that reincarnate, when people reincarnate, they can reincarnate as a dog and a fowl and a goat, even a tree. Brothers and sisters. But brothers and sisters, how come if reincarnation is not true, but how come is only one aspect of reincarnation they're looking at, the human part? Because if they teach that you can reincarnate as a dog or a cat, how come they're not going to investigate where anybody come back as a dog or a cat? It's only on the human aspect. Something is wrong there. So you mean to say, in that doctrine of reincarnation, nobody never reincarnate back as a cat or a dog? No, I want to show the doctrine contradicts itself. Because if somebody reincarnate back as a dog, how do we know that this dog is different from the normal dog? Will the person reincarnate back as a dog? Will he be barking? Okay. Will he be barking or talking like a human being? So they will say, well, he's in the shape of a dog, but he's talking in human voice. So they will know the distinction. We're not seeing that, brother. We are not seeing that, sister. So it shows you all that doctrine of reincarnation is false. You know why? Because they're only looking at the human aspect of it. Why come no dog is not coming up to the researcher, talking in a human voice and telling the researcher, researcher, reincarnation researcher, I am reincarnate as a dog now, as I see a talking in the shape of a dog, but a talking in a human voice. But I is the man who live in India, my name was John. Are you all seeing that? All you're not seeing that. Why what you all are seeing is human being claiming they reincarnated in the past. Why is only human being saying they reincarnate in the past? When the doctrine teach that you reincarnate back as human being, as animals too. So you see, that doctrine is one side. Now if that doctrine is true, then that doctrine needs to be manifest in its entirety. But the doctrine, this is just an example. But we see the doctrine is only being manifested in one aspect. So you tell you that doctrine is wrong, and there is no transparency in that doctrine. No one haven't taught you all that. Well, I, Eric Rexon, is teaching you all that. So now you all will put on all the thinking cap and recognize that what I'm teaching you all is true. And you look at all these videos, is only human aspect they are teaching. Only the little boys and seeing the living past life. But all they're not seeing no donkey coming up. A donkey in a living donkey talking in a human voice, telling the researcher, I am in a donkey form now, but I was the woman who lived in Sri Lanka. Are they seeing any donkey doing that? No, only he's seeing human beings doing that. So that teach all of that doctrine is false. Because if reincarnation was true, the whole aspect of that doctrine had to manifest in its full manifestation, not only on the human side, but on the animal side. What we only see in that doctrine is only on one side, only human beings claiming they reincarnated like other human beings. That is false. Have anyone taught you all that? Have you all heard that from anyone? Well, then it's the first time you will be hearing from Eric Braxton, this little boy way down in Trinidad and Tobago. And please, do not come looking for me to spend all the money to look for me. Look at me in my videos. See what I'm teaching you all in my videos. Accept the truth. And you all, if you all look at all these videos on the internet, whether there be 5 million videos on the internet concerning reincarnation, you all will know that all these videos are false now. By this 10-minute truth in this video that I'm bringing all to the fore, to bring it all to the mind, all in mind, that clarity, that comprehension, that enlightenment, above all, that spiritual edification, and above all, this truth teaches you all that reincarnation is false and it cannot be proven. My dear friends, is this a deception? Is this a theory? My dear brothers and sisters, well, is anyone out there want to challenge me and record a video to challenge me according to you all, what I'm saying is foolishness, and what I'm saying doesn't make sense. Okay, well therefore let us let the challenge begin. 1, 2, 3. All you intellectuals out there, and all you academics out there with all the PhD and MA and think tank university, with all the bachelor degrees and think tank and PhD, then if I, what I, Eric Braxton, I have none of these things. There's nothing wrong having these things. But since you all have it, and you all are saying this little Christian boy, Eric Braxton, from the island of Trinidad and Tobago, is talking foolishness, well then you all bright boys, bring a kettle, find where someone is reincarnate in the form of a kettle right now, and bring him in Times Square. And let us hear he talking in a human voice. I'm proving that he live in a next form in England, but now incarnate as a cattle. Bring him in Times Square and videotape him talking, so we will prove now that he really incarnate in a form of a cattle. Don't bring no human beings saying that. Now if you all on the, all you say are talking stupidness, well then look, don't look for only the human beings who say they reincarnate. Now go and find animals now who say there was reincarnate. This is a challenge to you all now. It come to that now. It have come to this now. So this is a paradigm change have taken place now. This is a paradigm shift and change of ideas have taken place now. So that is for you all to do now, to prove what I'm saying is true. Do not go and look for no human beings who claiming they reincarnate. Go and find animals who talking in human voice, claiming they were reincarnate, and bring them in Times Square, where everybody could see you all are interviewing the animal, talking in human voice, and saying they live in a past life. That is all your job to do now. That is not my job. I have completed my job by teaching you all this and revealing these facts to you all, to show you all reincarnation is false. But since you all want to prove that I talk in foolishness, then that is all your part now, to get the animals to prove what I'm saying is wrong, talking in human voice, and don't interview them in a private setting. Interview them in the public domain, where everybody will see you all are talking to the animals, and the animals are talking back to you all, claiming they reincarnate in a next life. They live in a next life in a human being, but now they reincarnate in an animal form. Is you all have to find these animals now. Since you all do not want to accept what I say, and since you all are stubborn-hearted and disobedient, I want to reject what I say, and still want to hold on to the theory of reincarnation. Now, you all have all a job cut out for you all to do. Well, I, Eric Braxton, will be waiting and see who will be taking up this challenge. Waiting, I'm looking to see if anyone will come to the fore to take up that challenge, to find the animals, to do the interview with them, and the animals will be talking fluently, claiming they live in a past, that they live as human beings in a past life, but now they incarnate as animals, because that's what the doctrine of reincarnation teach. Right, so you all have a job to cut out for you all. Well, I end the video now. The ball is on the court. I wait patiently, my dear brothers and sisters. Shalom, peace. See you all in the next video soon. Bye-bye, my friends.